Welcome home, Lord.
She'll see you at once.
They're sick people, not criminals.
We've gone beyond that question, Your Majesty. They're
my citizens, and we will save them from the plague if we can. All of them.
Very well.
We will not speak of this again.
Mother, Corvo is back.
Thank you, Emily. Leave us, please.
As you wish, Your Majesty. Corvo, 2 days early. Full of surprises, as usual.
Follow me, it's Captain. A fair wind that brings you home to me. What news have you brought? Cities had dealt with this before, knew of some cure. Corvo, thank you. If you hadn't been here...
No more! Not again!
Mommy! No!
Get away from her! Corvo!
Mommy! Get away! Corvo!
Corvo... It's all coming apart. Fine... Find Emily. Protect her. You're the only one. You'll know what to do. Won't you? Corvo.
Ward us all. Look at what he's done.
Yes, he's killed the Empress. What did you do with young Lady Emily, traitor?
Her own bodyguard. Ironic.
I'll see you beheaded for this, Corvo. Take him.
You should eat, Corvo. This meal comes from a friend.
What the boy was that? What the fuck?
Get around him!
Flank him!
Take out his leg!
Don't fall apart.
Get it!
Thank you.
explosive to blast his way out. It doesn't happen by accident.
You think he had help? Who'd know how to do that?
Dunwall citizens, the assassin Corvo, responsible for the murder of our fair empress and the disappearance of Lady Emily, heir to the throne, has temporarily escaped state custody. Any evidence as to his whereabouts must be delivered to the city watch at once.
Don't get past me, sir.
Do you want
it? Assassin, help! Flank him!
Hey, what was
it? You're going down. I bet we'll see that guy again.
Think of
the worms! Flank him!
Get him!
Take him!
Attention, Dunwall citizens. The assassin Corvo, responsible for the murder of our fair empress and the disappearance of Lady Emily, heir to the throne, has temporarily...
Over here. I'm Samuel, and I work for some good people who want very much to meet you. They said you'd come out here. I can still hardly believe it. I'll take you to meet them. Just down the river from here.
This is the Hound Pit's pub. Closed for business. Half the district marked off is dead from the plague. We're right under the Lord Regent's nose, and he don't know a thing. Of course, if anyone finds out what we're up to, the Watch will break in with swords drawn. And now that you've escaped, the Lord Regent's going to be tearing the city apart. Take you up to meet Admiral Havelock and the rest of the Loyalists. The Admiral's a man to be reckoned with. If anyone can help you find that missing girl, Lady Emily, and clear your name, he can.
So it's starting at last, Admiral.
We can continue this later, Lord Pemp. Yes. Piero's as much an artist.
I'll be crafting your way.
Can you get a new tank from upstairs, please, while I hold this in place? Careful. Oil's unstable. The minute it explodes, there is a terrible mess. Perfect. Thank you. Tell me what I can make for you. You must be exhausted. I advise that you get some sleep. Your life will get even more difficult soon. You should rest while you can. Sleep well.
Hello, Corp. How you use what I...
Well, another thing. Campbell is holding a former overseer by the name of Mark.
Ready to go? Just give the signal. It'll be a rough trip. Used to be to go straight up Clavering Boulevard, but now it's not so easy. Half the city's dead of the plague, the other half's fighting over what's left. City Watch still holds the bigger streets, and they've set up those wall of light checkpoints. A man walks through one of those, and he ends up burned to a crisp. Everything not controlled by the City Watch is gang territory. Then there are the real odd birds living on the fringes, like that Granny Rags. They say she's nuts. Don't know which is worse. Just take your pick.
Alright, I won't be of any help here, so I'll make my own way back to the home.
I was just reading in the archive about the heretic's brand.
It sounds familiar. Have you ever seen the ritual? I've never seen the Heretic's brand used. No, it's a rare occurrence. But I did spy the face of one so branded. A former member of our order, of course. Out on a retreat, we passed through a fishing town.
I hear the watch is having trouble holding the side streets.
Bunch of children. Games, that's what it is.
Good, good. And your niece, Callista, isn't it? I'm very concerned about her.
She'll be found. My men are searching district by district.
The poor girl.
Callista's a resourceful one. Probably found a safe place to hole up in all this chaos.
If my overseers hear any word, I'll come straight to you. Time for drinks. I hope you won't refuse. This business pass all the quicker. Locked? One of the servants must have been in here. Let me see. It seems I have the wrong one.
Not that one.
No. Ah, here we are. Now if you'll join me.
I'll get you now.
Hey, Corvo. From the way I hear it, Campbell lived a pretty posh life. Maybe it's not my place to say, but men of the faith shouldn't live like barons. Are you ready to go? Okay, let's go. Lord Pendleton are in the courtyard. I expect they'll want to congratulate you.
They're all corrupt. If this is going to work, you did it.
Living on the north side of the river.
Hello, Cole.
Every citizen's duty to report three.
Corvo.
Pendleton's waiting for you on the dock. He's asked to brief you personally.
Corvo, my friend, do you need ammunition or weaponry? Would you like me to craft something for you?
I'll take you to the Golden Cat when you're ready. I've taken Lord Pendleton enough times, believe me. I'll get you as close as I can to the Golden Cat, Corvo. You'll have to go the rest of the way on your own. The entrance is near Holger Square. The main thing is to make sure that little girl, Emily, gets back all safe and sure. Them two Pendletons are there, so I'm guessing there'll be a lot of guards. Slackjaw might have some ideas on helping you get inside the Cat, if he don't kill you. This here's his territory. He and his Bottle Street gang hole up at the old Dunwall Whiskey Factory. They sell the elixir that folks use to fight off the plague. I'll lay low, but keep an eye out for you and the little lady you're bringing back. Good luck to you. I know Emily must mean a lot to you. Be careful going up the street, Corvo.
Attention, Dunwall citizens. Anyone?
Somewhere, scum. I heard you there.
Oh, damn.
Help! He got his legs.
Oh, please no. Help me!
For the
there you go, outsider. Black magic! part to the Hound.
Finally.
Take that.
Not sure what that was. The door is locked. Unlock it so we can get... This place is on the river, so you must have come by boat. I'll wait for you near the boat. I remember the way. Don't worry about me.
Come on. Come to dinner now, that's right. My sweet little bird. Come to Granny. Granny won't hurt. Have you seen him? The handsome one with the beautiful dark eyes. I just want to tell him I'm doing my
now in effect. Non-compliance is a punishable offense.
Are you both ready to go?
He's going to show me how to
steer his boat. Corvo, you must have worked wonders out there in the city tonight. I can't believe my old eyes. So you did the business, did you, Corvo? I'm not one to speak against my betters, mind you, but if anybody ever deserved their fate, it was those Pendletons.
What business are you talking about?
Oh, grown-up business, girl. I mean, your ladyship. Forgive me.
It's okay. I heard a lot of grown-up business at the Golden Cat.
Oh. I should concentrate on piloting this boat.
Young Lady Emily, I'm Callista. I'll be caring for you and schooling you while you're with us.
Pleased to meet you.
As am I. Would you like to see your room in the tower?
Can I see it?
Yes, you may. You'll get to see it all. The entirety of the Hound Pits.
Good. I think I'll like it here. I'll go with Callista, Corvo. I'll see you later.
You do not fail to impress. Armed with a blade, you've changed the course of the city forever. And with the Pendleton twins gone, our own Lord Pendleton will assume their votes in Parliament. In one night, you've done more than most men do in a lifetime. I need to speak to you soon. But for now, Lord Pendleton requests your attention.
Corvo, the Lord...
Ask me for any gear you need.
All right, my
critical low point. Ordinary citizens will be limited to purchasing half a dozen per day.
Off to Caldwin's Bridge, sir. We'll get our sleep later. Just climb aboard when you're ready. What do you think, Corvo? Caldwin's Bridge. Been in the city for years, but you lived in Dunwall Tower with the late Empress, so maybe you haven't visited the bridge before tonight. Something to look out for. See all them lights on the water? That's right. We'll be spotted for sure. You're gonna have to shut off their power before I can pick you up. Now, about bringing Sokolov back alive. He's smart. Maybe even smarter than Piero. Got the whole of Dunwall under his thumb with all that natural philosophy business. New technology, potions and the like. Seems dangerous to me. But what do I know? Here we are. I'll meet you at the arches under Sokolov.
Curfew means ain't nobody allowed to be just wandering about, except us.
Firing! Get around it!
Citizens and visitors to our city, by order of the region, the curfew is now active. No foot traffic is allowed across Caldwin's Bridge until curfew is lifted. Attention all citizens, no pedestrian movement is allowed along Caldwin's Bridge during this period. Curfew will end tomorrow morning at sunrise.
Rivers chain.
I know something's up. Heard something.
What? Help me look for
it. Don't get the river.
Got you now. Blow off, chopper. impossible.
Sokolov is testing elixirs on people to cure the plague. Why is it he always asks for help with assassins? If you follow my meaning, sir.
You have no money. All these rats.
I'm not asking to know what's going on up there. I was just asking if you heard the screams, too.
Of course I've heard them. I would be more worried if there were no screams.
Now turn my hope.
What?
How did you? I can't say I'm surprised. I knew someone would come eventually.
I need assistance. Now!
Are bad. Could the city get any worse?
Never know.
Happy to hear it, but otherwise you're just drawing attention to us.
The royal physician himself.
You made a neat job of it. Drop him here and we'll be off.
Set up a cell for Sokolov in the old kennel. Shackles and everything. It'll be a shock, him waking up in the straw and old dog poop. But from what I hear, he's woken up worse places. Guess we all have at that.
Well done, Corvo. Well done. I doubt a duck.
Corvo! Wake up! You were making funny faces while you were sleeping. I decided to nap here in your room while Callista was taking her bath. She told me if there's ever trouble, I should always run here. Callista will come get me when she's done with her bath.
Attention, Earthwall citizens. The Ascendancy.
Royal.
You're part of this rabble.
I hear you're off to the. You'll know him.
The Boyle costume ball, huh? Well, that'll be fun, but not for everybody. You ready? pulling out all the stops for the Boyle family. I didn't think there'd be tall boys patrolling here tonight. Watch yourself, Corvo. They don't fool around. The good news is, once you get to the party, that mask of yours will let you blend right in. Enjoy your evening out with the folk of quality. Better you than me.
Check.
You enjoyed your evening, sir. But we'd best be on our way. Quickly. Lord Pendleton said he would meet us here. I checked the wine cellar. Losing family gives a man a thirst.
Attention.
You did it. And now we've done away with a woman, and a noble woman at that. But Boyle was a viper. She helped the Lord Regent kill the Empress. So I don't feel a thing for her.
I've heard from Lord Shaw this morning. Which means my note was not delivered.
This puts me in an awkward position. But then, you weren't the one who said his wife had the face of a plague rat. Thank you. I will try not to overburden you in future missions.
You've had a long night, Corvo. But I fear it's not over. Havelock and Martin have already cooked up something more for you. They would like to see you now, in Havelock's chambers above the bar.
I trust you.
Do you need me to build something for you? I can make anything, practically.
Corvo.
Ready to face the Lord Regent? About time we took care of my say. Long past time. This is it, Corvo. Your last memories of Dunwall Tower might not be good ones, huh? So maybe you could make up for what happened back then. Be a bit of a climb from the waterlogged. Most important thing is killing the Lord Regent. Built himself quite a place at the top of the tower. Calls it his safe room or something. Crazy if you ask me. Another point of interest while I'm giving you the grand tour, Corvo. The broadcast control station here where all them announcements come from might be worth looking into. Ready? Next time I see you, the Lord Regent will be dead. And if not, well, it was an honor to serve with you.
Dunwall Tower personnel. All new assignments report directly to the duty officer.
Things are bad. Could the city get any worse?
Report, General Flash.
Everything is secure on the grounds, Lord Regent.
It won't hurt to check again. I'm going to head down and retire to my bedroom.
Begging your pardon, sir, but I think it would be best if you stay in your safe room on the roof for now.
I need the comfort of my own bed tonight. Your men can handle the tower security, so the guard if you have to. Come come see me before
you finish your rounds.
Yes, as you wish.
A citywide ban on whalers.
Please. Please don't hurt me. You're here to kill the Regent, aren't you? Spare my life, and I can help you beat him. He makes recordings on audiograph, secrets. Some that would destroy him if others heard. Played on this amplifier, his confessions would be broadcast throughout the city. He'll be ruined. The audiograph card you want is in a safe in the Lord Regent's room. But I was able to see the combination over his shoulder. 935. Trust me, what's recorded on that card will do the trick. Good luck.
If I explain, then you will see I am not at fault. My poverty around the city was meant to bring prosperity to the city, to rid us of those scoundrels who waste their days in filth and drink without home or occupation. The begging coin for which the rest of us toil, and it was a simple plan. Bring the disease-bearing rats from the Pandician continent. Your rounds.
Yes, as you wish, Lord Regent.
A citywide ban on wet. Please don't hurt me.
If I explain, then you will see I am not at fault. My poverty eradication.
What are you doing?
Is it all done? You ready to go back to the Hound Pits? Thanks to you, Corvo. All right, let's go. Big changes. Makes me uneasy, to tell the truth. A small fry like me always gets the worst of it. Maybe it's going to be different now. The Lord Regent is gone. The Abbey has a new High Overseer. I'm guessing our work is almost done. The others are in the bar. No doubt waiting to raise a glass in your name. Me, I think I'll just linger out here if you don't mind. Reflect on things while we have a moment. Congratulations, Corvo. Corvo.
She'll need higher mathematics. Samuel, you move like you've been drinking.
This is the one who was with the Empress when she died. Poison. Tivian stuff.
Amateur work. He'll live.
That's up to doubt.
A gift from your friend. The one who talks to you in the dark. Talks to you when you visit his shrines. I visited those shrines too. And I know what it felt like to shove a blade into your Empress. But I don't know you. Who you are, and who you fight for. You're a mystery. And I can't allow that. Against the ticking of the clock.
Leave us! I have to do this alone.
Are you frightened? Corvo, the terror of Dunwall. Is this how you...
What was that?
No!
This was too
easy. I'll find you.
Please, no. Oh, it's you, Corvo. Thank the stars. We all thought you'd been killed. Except for Samuel.
What a shame. Gotta be a great woman.
Men are still trying to.
What the? Curse the outside.
Come on, what do you do? Stand clear.
Take it. Watch it. We know you're here.
Huh? Hey, what was? I know I heard something. We gotta be here somewhere.
What the void was that?
He's here.
Can't believe we lost him.
Eat metal! Dump you in a river!
I
heard you there.
I can't believe you're alive. They killed everyone, Corvo. They killed everyone to cover it all up. Then they took Emily with them and they left. I couldn't do anything to protect her. Please find her. Make her safe. All his talk of being an honorable.
Thought I'd find you here. Never pays to bet against you, does it? I saw the signal. I knew you'd be back, Corvo. I knew it.
We'll need to get out of here soon. The Admiral controls the military now, Martin's high overseer, and Pendleton's in favor with the aristocracy and Parliament. They need Emily, of course. But if Havelock senses that it's all about to fall down around him, who knows what he's liable to do? Good. Then it's one more trip across the river to where it meets the sea. That's where the Lord Regent was building his new lighthouse. Ought to be something to see. This is it, sir. I suspect Havelock Martin and Lord Pendleton landed there a while ago and went into the lighthouse. Knowing them, they're not giving up without a fight. I remember hearing the Admiral and Martin talking about this place as where they'd hold up if they had to. Anybody going in has to breach the fort and the gatehouse. Then there's only one way to the top. All I can say is that it's been a pleasure serving with you. Maybe after all this is settled, we'll see each other again. Good luck, Corvo. If anyone deserves it, you do. I give my best to Emily. After she's on the throne, she won't have time for an old man.
Guards! Stand clear!
Stop messing around and come out!
Takes these damn things don't last long.
Hey, what was?
I don't know. Help! Damn you!
You think you're being quiet, bud? Get him!
Where are you?
Gotcha now. Take that!
Is it going to be okay now? Will I be Empress?
So ends the interregnum, and now Emily Caldwin I will take her mother's throne after a season of turmoil. You will stand at her side, Corvo, guiding her young mind and protecting her from those who seek to exploit her or cause her harm. You watched and listened when other men would have shouted in rage. You held back instead of striking. So it is with the passing of the plague and Emily's ascension, comes a golden age brought about by your hand. And decades hence, when your hair turns white and you pass from this world, Empress Emily, Emily the Wise, at the height of her power, will lay your body down within her mother's great tomb, because you are more to her than royal protector. Farewell, Corvo.